Hey guys, how's it going? Just want to do a little review on the CF2 IDE adapter, and this is sort of like a makeshift SSD or solid state drive. It sort of replaces the typical hard drive you have here, you know, pretty big, 3.5 inches wide, and this is pretty small. It's just you know, no bigger than a compact flash card. And you can see the interface cable there just goes straight into the motherboard. And it does pretty nice. I can't complain so far. I just installed Windows XP onto it just for testing purposes right now. But we got the monitor on there. And to turn this on, we have to short these pins right here. I don't know if you can see, but the focus is off a little bit. But I actually got rid of my other potato camera, so this is working pretty good. So we just have to short the upper two pins here. And there it goes. CPU fan's on. It's the HP there. The Windows is starting. It's booting off of this card right here. Yep, the operating system's running off this CF card. And you can see the little lights are working there. The red, yellow, and green. And here's the screen. It's a little slow at first, but it seems to be okay now. But just been testing a couple times. This is my third startup, and I can't complain too much. But it seems to be a little slow during startup. So if you press Control, delete, it usually gets you in there, but you can see we do have a usable desktop. You know, start button and everything like that works. My computer. And you can see it shows up as a removable disk. Usually, when you go into my computer, it's going to say local disk. But since this is actually a type of removable media, it's going to show up as removable disk C. So you can see our circle graph there. 1.14 gigs used, and it's a 4 gigabyte card. Even though it says 3.73, some of it's actually used by the system, so 3.73 is just available. So it has to use a quarter gig, you know, just for some system files. But everything seems to be working good with it. And just uses power from a floppy connector that you would find on your power supply, and it's using the regular IDE interface. You can see a big 40 pin connector, but otherwise we'll do a little shutdown here, so get the focus for you. Click shutdown and we'll shut it off. So that actually works pretty good, but I actually do have a CF2 SATA adapter in this beast, and I'll probably be trying that out tonight also. Might even do a little video on that. But I'm not going to install Windows XP on a 4GB CF card. I'm actually going to do a 16GB CF due to the fact when you install Office and some other programs, it really eats up the disk space pretty quick. So right now on this drive here, this SATA drive, it is a 40 gig, I believe. Yeah, 40 gig. I have about 8 gigs used, so I think a 16 gig is going to work fine, but we'll just have to watch for another video. Keep on watching.